Well, good afternoon. Would like to thank all of you for coming out. We are Trout Fishing in America. My name is Keith. His name is Ezra. And our first selection will be a song called When I Was a Dinosaur.
In this song, I will be a Tyrannosaurus Rex, the largest of all meat-eating dinosaurs. On my right, your left, Keith Grimwood will be a Triceratops, a short, squat, horny dinosaur. I used to be a dinosaur. I thought I was so cool. A future fossil fuel. That's all I ever was when I was a dinosaur. Everybody knew my name.
Hey, aren't you T-Rex?
Everyone respected me. I had a mighty roar when I was a dinosaur.
When I was a dinosaur, I almost weighed a ton. I had a lot of fun, caveman on the run.
When I was a dinosaur, I stepped in lots of mud. I walked around and snapped my teeth. Ate a lot of crud when I was a dinosaur. I had a little bitty brain. I never thought of anything I never knew before when I was a dinosaur.
When I was a dinosaur, I almost weighed a ton. I had a lot of fun, a caveman on the run.
When I was a dinosaur, I thought I was so cool. Future fossil fuel, that's all I ever was. When I was a dinosaur, that's all I ever was. That's all I ever was.
Thank you. We're going to do a song that we wrote for Halloween. It's a song called Big Trouble, about when the monsters came to play one afternoon. Kind of like the Beastie Boys go to daycare center. My parents went out this afternoon, and I was all alone. I sure wish I'd gone with them. Wish I'd never stayed at home. 'Cause I'm gonna be in big trouble when my parents get back today. 'Cause this afternoon the monsters came to my house to play. There was a dragon in the kitchen, that's why the ceiling's black. And a vampire drank all the Kool-Aid, and a witch chased off the cat. The fly threw up some oopy goop, and that's what clogged the drain. And the blob sat on the sofa, and he left an awful stain. And I'm gonna be in big trouble when my parents get back today. 'Cause this afternoon the monsters came to my house to play. Frankenstein wanted to play baseball, so I told him to play outside.
Didn't hear a word I said. That's how the TV died. What happened to the table? They're probably going to ask. Well, there was a big guy with a chainsaw and a scary hockey mask. And I'm gonna be in big trouble when my parents get back today. 'Cause this afternoon the monsters came to my house to play. Ghost went through the closet, locked the clothes all off the rack. And the mummy ripped the sheets up and wore them. He was starting to unwrap. A werewolf ate all the cookies, and he ate the cookie jar. And he was going to eat me too, so I hid behind the door. And I'm gonna be in big trouble. My parents get back today. 'Cause this afternoon the monsters came to my house to play. Yes, this afternoon the monsters came to my house to play.
This year, my favorite song that we learned is a song called 100 Little Ducks. It was originally called 100 Little Ducks, and I learned it as 100 Little Ducks, but because my partner over there is such a grump, we only do 5 Little Ducks.
You'll thank me for this.
Five little ducks went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, quack, 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 quack.
They didn't do it.
After mother duck says, everybody says, quack, 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 as loud as they can. Mother duck said,
quack, 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 quack.
But only 4 little ducks came back.
That's pretty good.
4 little ducks went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said,
quack, 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 quack.
But only 3 little ducks came back.
Aren't you glad we're not doing 100 ducks?
3 little ducks went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, but only 2 little ducks came back.
Okay, this time, boys only. Give me some very manly quacking, please.
2 little ducks went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said,
yes.
But only 1 little duck came back.
Okay, girls, your turn.
1 little duck went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, but none of the cute little ducks came back. So sad mother duck went out one day, over the hills and far away. Mother duck said, now how do you expect the 5 little ducks to find their way home if that's as loud as you can quack? Mother duck said, and all of the 5 little ducks came back.
Thank you.
was a song about a cat that came back. He didn't come with the ducks, but he came a little bit later.
Now old Miss Johnson lived all alone, had an old yeller cat that wouldn't leave home. She tried everything she knew to make the cat go away, but the cat came back the very next day. Thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, thought he wouldn't stay away. And she gave him to a boy going out in a boat, and she gave the boy a dollar just to set the cat afloat. Well, the boat tipped over and the boy drowned. 2 miles away they picked the boy up drowned, but the cat came back the very next day. Thought he was gone, but the cat came back, cause they wouldn't stay away. And she gave to a man going up in a balloon, and asked him for to leave him with the man in the moon. Well, the balloon burst and back to earth it head. 6 miles away they picked a man up dead, but the cat came back the very next day. Thought he was gone, but the cat came back, cause he wouldn't stay away.
Here's a verse, I think it was written by Stephen King, I don't know.
And she took him to the butcher when the butcher wasn't around, and she dropped him in the hopper when the butcher wasn't around. Well, the cat let out with a horrible shriek, and the town's meat tasted furry for a week, but the cat came back the very next day. Thought he was gone, but the cat came back, cause he wouldn't stay away. Now Miss Johnson lived all alone, had an old yellow cat that wouldn't leave home. She tried everything she knew to make the cat go away, but the cat came back very next day. Thought he was a goner, but the cat came back, cause he wouldn't stay away.
This is another song that we wrote. It's a song called I Think I'll Need a Band-Aid. You know, sometimes when you get hurt, can ask for a Band-Aid, and then maybe you need a little bit more than just a Band-Aid.
A cast.
A cast.
Traction.
All right.
There's a scratch on my finger from the cat. I was only petting him, who'd have thought he'd do that? It doesn't feel good, and there's a sliver of wood from a bench in the park where I sat. So I think I'll need a Band-Aid, or maybe three or four, and a bottle of that spray stuff we just got at the store. Some sticky tape, a roll of gauze, and if you'd be so kind, a washcloth and a piece of ice, but not the iodine. No iodine. There's a bump on my head from the wall. I hit it when I was playing with the beach ball. I was climbing in a tree when a fell and skinned my knee. It hurt, but I didn't cry at all. But I think I'll need a Band-Aid, or maybe three or four, and a bottle of that spray stuff we just got at the store. Some sticky tape, a roll of gauze, and if you'd be so kind, a washcloth and a piece of ice, but not the iodine. No iodine. There's a hole in the sleeve of my shirt. On my arm there's a scrape and some dirt. My friends were very sad, but I said it's not too bad. As a matter of fact, it doesn't even hurt yet. But I think I'll need a Band-Aid, or maybe three or four, and a bottle of that spray stuff we just got at the store. Some sticky tape, a roll of gauze, and if you'd be so kind, a washcloth and a piece of ice, but iodine. I think I'll need a Band-Aid, yeah, maybe three or four, and a bottle of that spray stuff we just got at the store. Some sticky tape, a roll of gauze, and if you'd be so kind, a washcloth and a piece of ice, but not the iodine. No iodine.
Okay, well, we don't just want this show to be fun today. We want it to be educational. We know you're all very concerned with matters like this, and we'd like to start out with, this is the educational part of our show, the next four songs or so. I would like to start with English, and we're going to study the vowels right now. Do you know your vowels? Let's go through them. A, E, I, O, U. Well, we're going to take the words apples and bananas, and we're going to sing this song, and we're going to change the vowels around a little bit up and see what it does to these words. You can sing along if you'd like.
I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to oat, oat, oat apples and bananas. I like to oat, oat, oat apples and bananas. I like to oot, oot, oot apples and bananas. I like to oot, oot, oot apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas.
Thank you. And we'd like to do my favorite right now. This is a history song. Song about coffee through the ages. A sultan sat on his oriental mat in his harem in downtown Persia. He took a sip of coffee, just a drip, and he said to his servant, "Curse ya! Ah, curse ya, curse ya, curse ya! That's the worst cup of coffee in Persia. Cause all I want is a proper cup of coffee made in a proper cup of coffee pot. I may be off my dot, but I want a proper coffee in a proper copper pot. Iron coffee pots and tin coffee pots, they are no use to me. If I can't have a proper cup of coffee in a proper copper coffee pot, I'll have a cup of tea." In days of old, when knights and men were bold and whiskey was much cheaper, Ben Turpin rode to a coffee shop and showed his pistols to the keeper. He said, "Stand and deliver! Can't you see that I'm all a quiver? Cause all I want is a proper cup of coffee made in a proper copper coffee pot. I may be off my dot, but I want a proper coffee in a proper copper pot. Iron coffee pots and tin coffee pots, they are no use to me. If I can't have a proper cup of coffee in a proper copper coffee pot, I'll have a cup of tea." Da 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 da. When Bonaparte found that he was in the cart and he lost that Waterloo fight, he gave his sword to Wellington, my lord, and he said, "Those bitches can't have fight. Now you've had your Waterloo. Tell me what? Am I heaven with you, sir? Well, he went to the bed, kept the coffee made in the bed, kept the coffee pot. He made the earth mud, that the bed, went to bed, the coffee in the bed, kept the pot. And coffee pots, and tin coffee pots, they are no use to me. If I can't get a pepper, kept the coffee in a pepper, kept the coffee pot, he had a cup of tea." Now King Solomon and his queen would carry on, so we heard in the ancient scandals. He bought her lots of silver coffee pots with diamond legs and handles, and said the Queen of Sheba, "I'd rather have any old Teba, cause
All I want is a proper cup of coffee made in a proper cup of coffee pot. I may be off my dot, but I want a proper coffee in a proper copper pot. Iron coffee pot, sent in coffee pot, say I no use to me. If I can't have a proper cup of coffee in a proper cup of coffee pot, I'll have a cup of tea. All I want is a proper cup of coffee made in a proper cup of coffee pot. I may be off my dot, but I want a proper coffee in a proper copper pot. Iron coffee pot, sent in coffee pot, say I no use to me. If I can't have a proper cup of coffee in a proper cup of coffee pot, I'll have a cup of tea. All I want is a proper cup of coffee made in a proper cup of coffee pot. I may be off my dot, but I want a proper coffee in a proper cup of pot. Iron coffee pot, sent in coffee pot, say are no use to me. If I can't have a proper cup of coffee in a proper cup of coffee pot, I'll have a cup of tea.
Music education now. The instrument that I am playing is called a string bass. It is called a double bass. It is called many other names.
A doghouse bass. A Texas fiddle.
Yeah, it's called that. That's right.
Martha.
There are many ways to play the bass. When I use my bow, we call it arco, and it sounds like this. When I use my fingers, it's called pizzicato, and it sounds like this. The instrument Ezra is playing is called a guitar. Oh, yeah, you knew that, right? Okay, well, there's a lot of ways to play guitar, too. You can play guitar with your fingers.
Which is called playing with your fingers.
Sounds like this. Or you can play the guitar using a guitar pick, and it can sound like this.
It's called playing with your pick.
You could also play the guitar with your shoe, and it would be called playing the guitar with your shoe, and it would sound just like this. Very nice.
Thank you.
Well, there are lots of ways to play your instrument. And there are lots of ways not to play your instrument. We're going to explore some of these possibilities. The song was originally entitled Feuding Mandolins. I ask you, do you see a mandolin on this stage? Do you?
No.
They changed the name to Dueling Banjos. Do you see a banjo on this stage?
No.
They changed the name to Dueling Morons. Do you see any morons on this stage?
Yeah.
Okay, it's called Dueling Morons then.
Thank you.
With my right hand, I'm going to draw a square. And with my left hand, I'm going to draw a triangle. And I will recite a tongue twister with my mouth, all at the same time. Rubber baby buggy bumpers, rubber baby buggy bumpers, rubber baby buggy bumpers, rubber baby buggy bumpers, rubber baby buggy bumpers.
Right hand, I will draw a circle. My left hand, I will draw a circle. With my mouth, I will recite a tongue twister, all at the same time. Rubber baggy buggy bunkers, rubber baggy buggy bunkers, rubber baggy buggy bunkers, rubber grabby guggy gunkers.
Now, just for this show, we had this milk. We found this milk outside today. They kind of threw it away, and this is old, lumpy, sour, gross milk! You know, the kind you get in lunch line sometimes. You drink it real quick, and you swallow it, and the lumps go down your throat, and then you taste real bad. You remember? It's gross, isn't it? I'm going to put this on my head. What if it falls? Harder than it looks, Keith.
You know what it is. You know the dangers involved.
Drink it. What?
Drink it! Drink it? You drink it.
Maybe if everybody blew real hard, it would fall off.
Okay, now it's time for Hobby Corner. This is where we get to have fun. We are not professional jugglers, folks, but we like to do this anyway. May I present Ezra Idlet and the Devil Sticks. Ezra learned how to use the Devil Sticks in a motel room in Austin, Texas. He took him 2 weeks to do it, and one day he made a mistake.
Uh-oh.
He liked the mistake, so he did it again.
Uh-oh. Again.
I said, Ezra, that is a cool mistake. Can you make the same mistake with your other hand?
Uh-oh, with the other hand. And that.
Well, it was getting real dark in the motel room. So we opened up the curtains and looked outside, and we noticed there was a helicopter flying by. I grabbed the binoculars, and sure enough, it was a one-handed helicopter. The helicopter nearly crashed because there was an airplane flying too close by. The pilots were trying to watch cheerleader practice over at the football stadium. Oh, I've seen you've been an audience before. That's good. Very good.
Cheerleader practice.
Cheerleader.
Ho, oh, here we go.
Yay!
And now my partner, Keith Grimwood, is going to perform a juggling routine that is so exhausting that by the end of it, he will be sound asleep. This is what most jugglers call a cascade pattern. The balls are doing a cascade. Now we're going to perform a reverse cascade. Now juggle tennis. Juggle tennis. Watch the ball. Keith loves this. Over. Now he's going to perform animal imitations. A brief animal imitation of a lizard. And what do lizards eat?
Flies!
I can see it. He's getting tired right now. He's losing and he's going to take a nap. This is the laziest juggler I know, ladies and gentlemen. He's going to sleep on a job.
Ezra's so indecisive when he starts juggling, can't make up his mind which one to juggle. But when he gets down to it, he's very scientific in his approach. He'd like to show you the unstable molecule first. And now the yo-yo.
Yo-yo!
Hey, the other yo-yo, come on. Yo, 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 yo. Now the oi, 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 oi. All right, and for his grand finale, he's going to throw two behind his back and continue juggling.
It's my turn. Go, go, it's my turn, my turn.
Well, I don't know about this.
Clubs.
Clubs, okay.
The giant two-headed midget.
We call this interactive juggling. Well, now that you've seen what expert jugglers we are, we're going to need a volunteer, folks. We're going to need a volunteer from this audience. Ezra, could you pick a volunteer for me? This is extremely dangerous, what we're going to be doing. Folks, these are not ordinary juggling clubs. What these are, really, are razor-sharp knives encased in plastic. And these knives will be whooshing.
Pushing. This is Sarah, by the way. Say goodbye to your friend, Sarah. Say goodbye. Put your hands at your side. Put your chin out. Stick your tongue out. Good, 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 good. Don't move when we do this. Don't mess us up or we'll mess you up.
Are you scared?
I was talking to him.
A little bit.
Okay, don't move. Don't move, please don't move. Okay, ah! Okay, fine, fine. Calm under fire. Hup, hup, ah! Ah! Oh! Ah! Silence! Now! 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 Now!
I'll sing you a song, lullaby. Sleep till morning comes. The crickets serenade, echo softly through the night. The stars are on the lake, and the moon is shining bright. Don't worry, I'll leave a light on in the hall. Just go to sleep now, close your eyes. Close your eyes. Listen to my song, lullaby. Sleep till morning comes. The birds are in their nest, and the cows are in the barn. The covers on your bed will keep you safe and warm. Don't worry, I'll be beside you should you call. Just go to sleep now, close your eyes. Dragons in the sky, flying with their golden treasure. And if you catch their eye, wishes granted more than you can measure. I'll be beside you should you fall. Just go to sleep now, close your eyes. The crickets serenade, echo softly through the night. The stars are on the lake, and the moon is shining bright. Don't worry, I'll leave the light on in the hall. Just go to sleep now, close your eyes. Just go to sleep now, close your eyes.
Thank you.
When it's time for bed, it's time to find the teddy bear, right? Can you all please say, hello, Mr. Bear?
He's saying hello back to you.
It's one of his cousins is sitting there in the front row, right there.
This is a song called The Teddy Bear's Picnic, and it was written way back in 1907. Mr. Bear's gonna sing this entire song without moving his lips. The woods today, be sure for a big surprise. If you go out in the woods today, you better go in disguise. For every bear that ever there was will gather there for certain, because today's the day the teddy bears have their picnic time for teddy bears. The little teddy bears are having a lovely day today. Watch them catch them unaware. See the picnic on their holiday. See them gaily get about. They love to play and shout. They never have any care. At 6 o'clock, their mummies and daddies will take them home to bed, because they're tired little teddy bears.
Mr. Bear! Thank you. Well, you have been a wonderful audience. Give yourselves a hand. That's really, really good. Thank you. We got one more song to do for you, and it's a nursery rhyme polka. And here's the way it's gonna work. We're gonna take all of your favorite nursery rhymes, those that you treasure near and dear to your hearts, and we're gonna mess them up. Georgie, Porgie, Puddin' and Pie kissed the girls and made them cry. When the boys came out to play, they threw him out the window, the window, the window. They threw him out the window. When the boys came out to play, they threw him out the window. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men, they threw him out the window, the window, the window. They threw him out the window. All the king's horses and all the king's men, they threw him out the window. Little Miss Muffet sat on her tuffet, eating her curds away. Along came a spider and sat down beside her. She threw it out the window, the window, the window. She threw it out the window. Along came a spider and sat down beside her. She threw it out the window. Peter, pumpkin eater, had a wife who couldn't beat her. Put her in a pumpkin shell and threw her out the window, the window, the window. He threw her out the window. Put her in a pumpkin shell and threw her out the window. Mary had a little lamb, little lamb, little lamb. Mary had a little lamb. She threw it out the window, the window, the window. She threw it out the window. Mary had a little lamb. She threw it out the window. Jack Sprat could eat no fat, his wife could eat no lean. So between themselves, you see, they threw it out the window, the window, the window. They threw it out the window. So between themselves, you see, they threw it out the window. It's story time! Hey there, little Red Riding Hood, you sure are looking good. You're everything a big bad wolf could. Throwing out the window, the window, the window. Throwing out the window. You're everything a big bad wolf could. Throwing out the window. And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, moms and dads, we are going to attempt something incredibly difficult. We're going to sing two nursery rhymes at the same time, a cappella, forcing you to use both halves of your brain at the same time, a cappella. I'm going to be singing Rub-a-dub-dub, Three Men in a Tub, and Ezra's going to be singing...
There wasn't a woman who lived in the shoe.
Please don't try this at home without adult supervision. It's extremely dangerous, and
we are professionals.
Could you count it off, Ezra?
One, two, three.
No, no, no. Could you count it off enthusiastically, please? I can't get into it.
One, two, three!
There wasn't a woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children she didn't know what to do. She spanked them all soundly and put them to bed.
Throwing out the window, the window, the window. She threw them out the window.
She spanked them all soundly and put them to bed.
Throwing out the window.
Thank you very, very much.
Go fish.